Welcome to part two in setting up your course inside of Thinkific. We're going through step by step. And in this video, we are going through custom domains. So we have upgraded to the basic plan, and part of the basic plan is that allows us to use custom domains. So what does that mean? So if you look up top in the URL bar here, you'll see it says Marg S School 21AO and some characters .thinkific.com. This is what we're going to change because we don't want to have to tell people to type this in. We want something that's a little more human readable. So what you need to do is you need to go to a domain registrar and register a domain. You cannot register a domain through Thinkific. So what we need to do is register it externally, and then we're going to hook it up to that external registrar inside Thinkific so that your site is now built on this new domain. There's no specific registrar you need to use. So if you want to use Namecheap, GoDaddy, Domainer, whatever you like. I use Domainer, and the only reason I use it is because I started using it and I want all my domains to be in the same account. So I've got mine inside Domainer, but what you'll need to do is open up your domain registrar in a separate tab and navigate over to that domain. It's going to vary whatever portal you go into, but if you go into the domain, you'll see something like manage DNS settings, manage DNS records. You might have to go into products, domains. I think if it's GoDaddy, you'll have to go to products, domains, manage DNS records. And then when you open it up, I'm going to click on the DNS records here. It's going to open up something that looks similar to this. So it'll have like host name, type, value, might say like record type. When you open up type or look at the type, you should see a bunch of different record types in there as well too. Now in your specific DNS settings, this might have a bunch of fields already. So say you're using Gmail or Google Suite for your emails, a bunch of MX records what might be in there, and there could be some other records in there as well too. So we are going to be adding a new record. There could be certain cases, depending on the domain registrar, where you're actually editing existing records. But for this case, we're going to add a new one. I'll sort of show you what to do if we are editing existing records and what to keep an eye out for. But always know that your domain registrar can help you with things if you need to as well too. So you can hop on a chat with them, you can give them a call on the phone, anything you like. They should be able to also talk you through this. So the domain that I have chosen is called OCA-Think. So it's my online course academy and it's on Thinkific. Because on my channel, I'm setting up a bunch of different kind of online programs using a bunch of different courses. I just registered a bunch of domains here that are basically OCA-Think. OCA-teach for teachable and so on. So first off, I'm going to copy the new domain, OCA-think.com. And then I'm going to hop over to the Thinkific dashboard. Now in the Thinkific dashboard, I'm going to pop down to settings. And in the main site settings tab, you're going to go down to site URL. So it will give you the option to add custom URL. So we're going to click that. And we're going to paste our URL in there. Remember, it says down here, do not include HTTP, HTTPS. It's going to automatically do that for us. So just the straight up domain that you've purchased. We also want to make sure that this is checked called make primary, because if not, it's going to make it a secondary domain. And then it's still going to show up as this sort of awkward string of letters and numbers. So we do want to make it primary as well. So we'll go ahead and click save. Now it says host does not have a DNS record. What does that mean? So we're trying to add this new domain inside Thinkific, but we haven't tied that back to our domain registrar yet. We have to add a record in here saying, if you're looking up OCA-think.com, we actually need you to go to this specific Thinkific site. And we do that by adding a record. I'd like to take a second to thank today's sponsor, Segmetrics, the best analytics platform for all online course creators. I know many of us rely on tools like Google Analytics and Facebook ads to understand how to improve our marketing, but these web-based tracking systems have a hard time understanding subscription products and the lifetime value of our customers, which is the whole reason we have courses in the first place. Segmetrics automatically connects into your courseware that you're already using and lets you see not only where your most valuable customers come from, but what aspects of your courses keep people coming back for more, increasing engagement, and also ultimately reducing churn. So right now it's time to uncover the hidden profits of your marketing. And to make that even easier, Segmetrics is offering you 2 weeks absolutely free and 15% off your first 3 months with them.
All you have to do is go to segmetrics.io/marg. That's segmetrics.io/marg to take ownership of your marketing and start uncovering the hidden profits left in your funnel. Thank you so much, Segmetrics, for sponsoring this video.
There's a bunch of different record types, but we're going to be adding a CNAME record. So now that we know the type of record is going to be CNAME, what goes in these other fields? So for value, this is a pretty straightforward one because we're going to put the existing URL that our current site lives on. So if we pop over here, we're just going to grab this from the URL bar, but not the http://, part, just the whatever your school name is, .thinkific.com. And we're going to put that in the values. We see the green check mark. Great. The TTL has a default value, 3600. So that's like 3600 seconds. It means time to live. So it means like, when are these changes being implemented? And you can just leave that to the default. The host name, on the other hand, so this depends on your domain registrar. You can put www. In here, because what a lot of people don't realize is that www is actually just a subdomain of your root domain. So it's actually not your root domain, but it's a subdomain of it. So this is kind of a workaround. If you want it to be on oca-think.com, you can put this website on www.oca-think.com, which to everyone visiting it, www doesn't really look like a separate subdomain like courses would. So it looks like it's on the core domain. And then you would forward the root domain to this www version. So that's what we're going to do. We've got all green check marks here, and I'm going to go add. We're going to save our DNS settings. Now, DNS technically can take up to 72 hours to what's called propagate. Usually it doesn't take that long. I've had maybe two instances in my life, in my career, that it's taken 72 hours or longer. Generally, it's less than an hour, maybe 3 hours max, but there is a site that you can use called What's My DNS, and it's a propagation checker. So if we load up our new URL in here, which is www.oca-think.com, and the record that we want to check is the CNAME, and we click search. Now we can see propagation. You can see a bunch of locations worldwide, and we can see that already it's starting to go to the Thinkific site. So this is working already. Let's check it out in the browser. So I'm going to copy this URL, and it says, here we go. Perfect. Great. So I saved it a couple times. Now it kicked me out because we have a new URL for the site, so we'll have to log back in. But if you see up in the bar here, and I'm going to click on it. Actually, I'll show you this. So see up in the bar, we don't see the www because it's sort of an internet standard and sometimes it doesn't show it. So but if we click on it again, we do see it in here. So we see we've got the www. All looks good. And we're going to sign in. Great. And once we sign in, brings us straight into our dashboard, and you can see in the URL bar, everything looks good. oca-think.com. Now we know it's www, but let's just test oca-think.com and see if there's forwarding in here. Sometimes there are forwarding mechanisms that happen behind the scenes. So again, depends on your domain registrar. So let's put this in without the www and we'll see if it forwards. So yes, it looks like after the DNS was changed, oca-think.com without the www, and it forwards to the www version. Now we have our domain all set up. So to summarize, we've got our domain purchased. That was done beforehand, and you have to do it through an external domain registrar. Remember, you can't purchase a domain through Thinkific, so use GoDaddy or Namecheap or Domainer, any one of those. You go into the settings of Thinkific, and we add the domain in there, now either with or without the www dot, probably with, because it's going to depend on the settings of the domain registrar. It's going to be easier if we use the www dot, and then it will take both of those and forward them to your site. So I would suggest using the www.version when entering that new domain in Thinkific. We also want to assign that to the primary domain. Remember, there's a checkbox for that. Then we pop over to our domain registrar and change the DNS settings by adding a CNAME. We wait. While we're waiting, we can check DNS propagation using what's my DNS and checking for the CNAME. As soon as we see that it's worldwide, we go back into Thinkific. We may have to wait a little while for it to configure even after it's finished propagation. I say leave it for 30 minutes, then come back and check it. But then we want to verify the domain in Thinkific, not only in the settings, but we want to check a couple different browsers, the with and without the www on our new URL to make sure that it's all going to the right spot. After that, we're done our domain setup. On to course upload in the next video.